can't do this. It's not tight enough. Oh my God, it's way too cold.
Hello everyone, I wanted to do a really real and raw week in my life as a 28-year-old content creator. Now, you may have seen a previous video on how I've made six figures and turned my life around. I was struggling financially for a long time, and today I'm going to show you into a life of what it really does mean to be a content creator and why and how I've made it. So I'm delusional to make this video because I don't normally do this. I've been thinking about it for about three or four times this week. I think I saw something online that if you're thinking about something more than three times in a week, it's a pattern, it's something you're interested in, it's something you should start doing. And so this is the first time I'm going to be doing this, but I really think what I'm doing is relatively interesting and hopefully helps you in some shape or form. But today I'm about to shoot for a big brand. You may have actually seen them. They're called the Magic Five, and they're on Shark Tank. I think Mark Cuban was fighting over these and putting big money behind them as well. So this is an ad that I've scripted, ideated, had a few calls at the start of this week to really figure out what creative direction we're looking at. And they want me to sort of star in it, deliver the script, and show the benefits of the product. So that's a big product I'm working for. I'm going to be doing a shoot with a lovely lady, my wife, who's going to help me in like an office setting. So I've booked an office for tomorrow, which is another B2B company, and they're called Happy Coaching. Big companies have started to work with me recently, and that's because I've put my best foot forward and believed in myself, because I never used to believe in myself in this creative industry. I've tended to sabotage my way to not feeling like I'm enough. I used to be a comic. I used to take the piss out of myself, not take myself too seriously. And I think that's led brands not to take me seriously. And as a result, jeopardized my opportunity. So I'm going to take you through what I do in a week. I'm going to become a new dad very soon. My wife's about to pop. But without further ado, let's take you further. Cheers. First things first, like once upon a time, I didn't have, this is a Sony FX30. This thing costs about $2,500. The light setup here is an Amaran 200D, I think it is. And it's a very good softbox light. And again, that's not cheap. That's about $300. And then there's another one here. This is my first light I ever started with as my key light. And again, I never knew anything about professional lighting, professional production. And I've just slowly and gradually built myself up to a point where I did want to invest in the production quality, because it then attracts better clients and makes you take your work more seriously. But I didn't start like this. I started with just an iPhone. Honestly, a light like this one, a little Godox light. Let me show you this one. A little Godox light. I started with that, a tripod and my phone. And that's what got me kicked off. And again, I think this is where, don't think you need this to begin with. If you feel like you're a talented content creator or just want to get your message out there, build your personal brand, I think it's highly worthy of just getting yourself online, being raw and real. And you don't need this production value. And this is where the practice comes in, you know, it's exponential growth. And you're kind of readying yourself up for this production value at some stage in your career. But giving yourself a go and building yourself incrementally makes you feel ready for the big productions. And, you know, you will not suffer so much with imposter syndrome when those big opportunities come from nowhere. So that's just a quick sign for you. This was not an overnight success. You know, this is an expensive microphone as well. And again, reinvesting in the business is another kind of mindset shift to have and sort of taking a bet on yourself. But anyway, I'm gonna get to shooting. They want a green screen video with proof of concept behind me with some green screen. And then we're gonna shoot at the beach in Australia. So I'm gonna show you a bit of beach as well, which will be fun.
I saw this episode on Shark Tank and was impressed how much the sharks were fighting over this company. I had to try it for myself. And here are five reasons why I love the Magic Five. One, no more red rings around my eyes. Two, no more water.
So change of plan. We were about to shoot at the beach in Chelsea Beach, which is a known Melbourne beach. Jazzy is feeling a bit knackered, so she's happy about that news. But anyway, probably I'll show you what I'm doing tonight. So tonight is going to be some scripting for another brand. It's going to be the shoot I'm doing tomorrow. So a lot of my time is spent scripting, coming up with ideas for companies, getting into meetings, doing some sales calls. And then the fun bit is the shooting. So that's what we'll be doing at the office tomorrow. And then at the beach.
Beach another day.
And that's another day. So we'll see that later on in the week. I will actually take you with me tomorrow for a gym workout as well. So show you the CrossFit gym, because CrossFit's, I can't do without it, my love, can I? Without CrossFit, I get cranky. Show us, there we go, that's a little one. She's about to pop. potentially in a few weeks. And again, I've got the hot.
Could be tomorrow.
Could be tomorrow, because when were you born?
37 and a half.
And she's at 37 and a bit, isn't she? 37 and a bit weeks. So it could be any moment, you know. Jazz has got her hospital bag packed. I've got the hotline ready to bell when I need to. Mm-hmm. And action stations when that happens. I don't know when, but let's hope.
Now we're home.
This is home, yeah, and we go. This is a lovely apartment we found in January.
These days, I'm so careful about setting boundaries around work, and I love to sit back, relax, watch our favourite series. Now, I used to be a man that never consumed, but consuming now is a nice relaxation. Sweet treat, you can never go wrong. And I used to be so conscientious around health too, but letting yourself go is really liberating. And again, just having this quality time with the missus is so key right now before two becomes three.
Good morning. It's a Wednesday morning. I'm just getting up. I'd love to show you exactly what I do for a brekkie. It's a very simple shake on the go with my Nutribullet. So what I do is grab my bottle. This is my ride or die. It gives me that kind of energy that's really fast releasing, very easy to digest. And first thing I eat in the morning. It's nothing too fancy, but I'm going to give you all the recipe for doing it. Let's rock and roll. I'll tell you a quick story. I saw a black widow. If you don't know what these are the world's most venomous spider in my kale.
You know you're in Australia when I'm cooking up my kale, having a nice bit of steak, right? I thought there's like a four-legged bloody creature dead in my steak. That thing. There's a black widow spider! A black widow spider in my steak! You know you're in Australia when you get black widows in your kale and steak. I'm not having it, dear. I'm not having it. It's a black widow.
Wash all that off. Squish that one down. And if that one green isn't enough, get yourself some frozen spinach. This is going to add that freshness. We want some cool feeling when we're drinking it. So again, frozen vegetables is always a good idea. Then mixed berries, blueberries, whatever takes your fancy, always a good addition. Now, what I tend to do is add some apple cider vinegar, a brilliant way, because I suffer with some gut issues. Sometimes I have a dicky tummy, which in UK urban language is a flatulence-based tummy. Don't like to naturally sweeten things. We can use honey if you want to sweeten it up, but I don't tend to do that because what comes in next is my protein powder. So again, a staple in anyone who's working out, needs to recover, you absolutely need some protein in there. Definitely go for an isolate whey, not something that's too processed, not something that's too cheap. You have to invest in your protein. Anyway, this is a creatine now, Crea8. This is an absolute game changer. What people say, it's like a accessible steroid, people call it. No, it's not. No, creatine is a fantastic way to gain performance. It's found in lots of red meats. It's kind of a great way for men, especially and women, to just get that performance enhancement. Then you want a thumbful of ginger, which I'm going to chop and pop in there, and half a banana if you want to sweeten it up a little bit. Again, that's about a quarter. I'll pop that in there. And we're nearly there to go. So I'm going to chop this up for you. You can hear a croak in my voice. So normally I'm getting up about, 7:30, 8 o'clock for my morning class. My morning classes are part of CrossFit. And again, this is another huge benefit of CrossFit. I'm a big advocate. I did the open about a week ago. Did not too badly.
Yep, that's me.
So that's it. So all you need now is a half cup of water. Now I'm going to just blend it up. Simple. And voila, there we go. I've got my fiber-filled juice smoothie here and my coffee in the morning. A little bit of a caffeine kick is needed. And I know what you're thinking. You're going to need an emergency exit to get to the nearest loo because this is like an explosive treatment. And just a quick look. These are my crepes, as you used to say. These are the training crepes. These are called the Nano X3s, the Reebok Nanos. Really, really recommend it for any sport athlete out there who just wants to get to the gym. Relatively priced as well. And if I've got time and I've watched the football and that's off the table, I do something called morning pages. It's a practice where you literally just let your stream of consciousness go for 5 minutes. There's no expectations. There's nothing you need to write. There's no structure you need to follow. And it's a really great way to just kind of puke out all the fears, the doubts, the limiting beliefs. And it gets you going on and taking action, I think. And yeah, I'm a big advocate for it. So if you get that 5 minutes in a day, definitely get it in. And just like that, I just filled out a page. Now, it might not hit 5 minutes. I just wanted to get something out. And it's a stream of consciousness. For me, something that came up was that perfectionism can get in the way. And I think finding the fun rather than being attached to figures, doing everything I can possibly do before the once-in-a-lifetime experience for me that's going to happen with my baby being born, putting my best foot forward, being that kind of masculine father who never regrets, never resents, and starts on things that he's always dreamed to do, which is vlogging. So for me, I need to keep myself accountable to keep this going. As much as video content I do on a professional level, I think just being real raw and just showing you the inside of my life can help more people out there, and especially not perform so much. I used to be a performer, I used to entertain. If you go back, if you're an OG out there, and let me know in the comments if you are, I used to be something called the health hunk, a great alias to get out of my comfort zone. And it was a nice layer of protection to my nice, fluffy, little vulnerable heart in here. And so I highly recommend doing that for now. But for me now, my intention is to really be as real and raw as I possibly can with you guys and show you on the inside of my life and document it rather than, you know, sit behind a table and talk on a deep topic, which of course that'll be some of the videos on my YouTube channel. I do want to talk on deeper stuff and have it an easier production, but vlogging is a great way to just document, show you what's really going on. Anyway, let's get to the gym. So just driving, I realized that sometimes music comes on that reminds you of like an ex, reminds you of a bad time, a bad memory. I find that when it comes on, you either take the initiative to try and move through it. Just like CBT, it's kind of like centering yourself, challenging yourself like a muscle to grow, that you're going to not allow it to emotionally take over you. You can practice that over time, but it takes time. Or you declutter your music library. For me, if you don't feel like you've got the willpower or it's a bit too fresh or frizzly right now, it's best to just remove the music, remove the clutter, remove the memorabilia that's going to overtake you and remind you of those times, because then you don't move on. There's no clarity or capacity to move on. And life, you deserve to move on. That's a quick one for you. I'll see you at the gym. There we go. That's the workout done at CrossFit 25, one of my favorite gyms I've worked out in yet. You know, I've done many gyms over the years, and this one seems like it is the most caring environment. The coaches really know what they're doing. The community is absolutely fantastic. So that's in Melbourne. If you fancy a CrossFit gym, say hello. And I've noticed in life, there's something called the Four Tendencies by Gretchen Rubin. And I notice I'm the obliger. So I meet outer expectations, but resist inner expectations. On a good day, I can do both. I meet both, and that's the upholder. And then if you're a rebel, you don't meet inner or outer expectations. And then if you're a questioner, you don't meet outer expectations, but meet your own inner expectations. And again, it's very nuanced. It's everyone's subjective. You don't fit a category, I know, but you probably resonate with one more than over than the others. And I'm an upholder. So when I know that and I train and play the decks in my favor, so I get to class, I make sure I've got a coach that keeps me accountable. I need to show up within time, not be late, and be part of a community, because then I'm meeting other people's outer expectations, and then I'm beating the game. Because otherwise, if I'm self-motivated, which I kind of am sometimes, then, you know, I'm upping the odds of success in that section. But go ahead, read the book, go online, take the quiz, and see which expectation quadrant that you are. It really helps you sort of navigate your life and see what to do to get yourself motivated. Anyway, that class was fantastic. There was lots of overhead squats. We did some runs, some biking, some presses overhead. And again, this is a sweet spot of 45 minutes of a workout, high intensity, and doing your best within that time. And then you can recover and then get back into that parasympathetic nervous system, which is sort of breathing, trusting your body that it gets back to soothing state and rest and digest. So I got to get home now, and I'm going to get straight into scripting the gig today with Jazzy. Jazzy, my lovely wife, is going to be on hand to film the shoot in the office. So let's see how it goes. There we go. Sorry you had to experience my concentration face. I'm a totally different person when it comes to staring at the screen and concentrating. But here goes the show. That's the script done for today. Also, I've got my hairband on, and it does remind me of the balding, male pattern baldness. And I will do a video about this, of how I'm embracing balding, because a lot of men are quite insecure about how their hairline recedes and how they're losing hair. Maybe it's a sign of you maybe feeling more fragile, you wanting to keep hold of your youth. Maybe there's a Peter Pan syndrome there, or just like, you know, being very self-conscious about your aesthetic and how you look. Now, I'm probably one of the people that needs to really worry about that, because my career could be on the line for it, because I'm in front of the camera quite often, and losing my hair could be quite a detrimental factor to opportunity. So I'm gonna do a video on that, actually, about how maybe I'm embracing it. Again, it's not come to a point where I'm actually too bothered, you know. It's all right as it is, and I quite like the idea of receding a little bit. It makes you feel like you're growing into a man and embracing that. Anyway, I wanted to give a quick tip to all creators as well. I've landed really good clients, a couple of reasons for it. Let me show you my proposal deck. So when I'm gonna do sales, and when I'm applying for jobs on Upwork, if I'm pitching directly through an ad I saw on a social media feed, and I'm just reaching out directly, I've created a proposal deck, which is very fancy. It's on brand. I've created my own brand, my own logo. And my wife even, Jazzy, is a fantastic designer, and she's helped me develop something really cool. So let me just show you in a second. Here is a really, you know, it's a really good way to show that you know your stuff. And in a proposal deck, you can see here, it's really showing my experience. And I'm basically gonna do a loom video. Every time I pitch to a client, I'm showing a personable approach. I do a loom over the top of all my experience, all my clients I've worked with, all the results I've gained. And again, this is social proof here, some testimonials, and a flawless review system here, showing I've got about 7 to 8 years of experience, and it's really lovely done. This is gonna set you apart from the rest of other people applying for other jobs. I know that image and aesthetic isn't everything, it's the product that counts, but I do believe if you're dealing with you know, luxury clients, those that have got bigger budgets, put the extra effort into your brand, your representation, and bring that personal touch. If you're doing a personalized loom call, just showing exactly what you can offer and really tailoring it to that client itself, you're gonna do so much better in a sales, and I found it to be an absolute game changer. So do develop a proposal deck. A high-level overview of who you are, what you've achieved for other companies very quickly. Have a portfolio, you know, your best client work. Show that off. One or two videos is enough. Then you're going to just show, you know, the proof of concept as you've done. It's more about why they should choose you. What results will you bring them? And again, hopefully your content itself speaks for itself. You know, they want someone who's representing the brand, somebody who's a creative through and through, because it's something they're genuinely outsourcing because they think that it takes too much time, or it's just not something they're good at. So that's what you need to show, that you're taking off their plate. And that's simply it. You know, I don't like all these marketeers overcomplicate these things, but that's all you need. But there we go, scripts are done. A couple of sales pitches have been done via Loom videos. And we're gonna get to the office to do the shoot. And I'm sort of trying to look like a CEO. Have I done a good job? I'll do my hair, get the spray on, and get going. So we've got 20 minutes to spare. We've booked this place called Waterman in Australia. Just finished the shoot. So we've got, you know, felt a bit stressed and rushed through to get 3 scripts done. Quite a cool company. They pay well, and done their landing page video. I think it was a VSL or a landing page video or an ad, whatever they're going to use it for. But again, this is, I don't know how many gigs I've done. I've probably done 100 at this point, but and thousands of hours in front of the camera. But just know that you're, with practice makes you better. It's a cliche, but before, when I first picked up a camera about 5 years ago, I was so unconfident. Like, I was rapping and tripping over my words in the mirror when I was trying to vlog.
Are you you! Get your hands out of the biscuit tin! I know you set a resolution for 2019. Get yourself an on-the-go workout program to something you can have for the win.
But these days, yeah, now you just kind of have to fake it till you make it. Fake that ideal self that you want to be, and eventually you'll create those neural pathways to become that person you've always dreamed to be. So I think I'm getting there. Not there yet, but at least give yourself a go, innit? My lovely wife behind the camera has been my videographer today, hence why I've got an extra pair of hands there. Anyway, yeah, this is the office. Actually cost us about 360 Aussie to rent for 2 hours. It's a 12 people office, very fancy. I mean, can you see that view out there? You've got like a panorama of a business park. Do you know what? It feels like that Thanos scene at the end of the Marvel, innit? Thanos. That's that. I'm going to get a coffee, going to head home, and I'll probably take you with us to tomorrow on the next shoot, because that's probably what's most interesting. We're going to go to Jazzy's, my in-laws, for dinner today as well, so that's fun. And chill out. I think this is it. We're going to upload all the footage and get ready for tomorrow, which is going to be at the beach. We'll show you an Aussie beach, one of our favourites, actually. And that's that, yeah. Here we've arrived, a little bit nippy, a little bit cold. I've got to get in that ocean, which is very tragic, with just some swim shorts on, just to shoot the brand, so we're going to be really quick. It's very, very cold, so let's get into it. This is a prime example of where expectations don't meet reality. Now, we thought this beach would be pristine blue, as you can see, a month ago when we used to chill out here, and this was the ideal for the shot with the goggles. Instead, it was a soup, murky, disgusting, and very cold.
I can't do this. It's not tight enough. Oh my god, it's way too cold. Oh, oh god.
Get your custom goggles now at www.themagic5.com and feel the difference.
The shooting was a bit of a disaster. We were hoping to get really clear goggle shots. Obviously, you saw a very windy ocean, which doesn't work. But what's beautiful is this area here is called Chelsea Beach, my favourite football team, and the road name, Bristol Avenue, where I'm from. This is Jazzy's childhood memory lane, this place. And she came every summer, didn't you, my love? This is Jazz's favorite beach, favorite road, of which is Bristol and Chelsea. So what a coincidence. So now we're gonna see if there's a pool to get some underwater shots for the goggles, but absolutely chilly. I think my balls shrunk right up to my spinal cord. It was that cold. Jazz is a trooper, pregnant, and still came and did a good job. So I think we've got the clips we need. Just a little cut, a couple more. And we'll review the footage in the car. So what I'm going to do now is review the footage, and that's another campaign that I've just done, showed you through the day, or the week I should say, in the life of me. But I think that's about it. So until the weekend, we tend to have a jolly go away on a cafe date or something like that, Jazz and I. And that's about it. I think I wouldn't give you any more insight of my life right now. Of course, there's going to be an exciting bump moment when baby is born.
Which could be a whole new video, how being a new father is and the stress, the excitement, the responsibility I'm taking on. But I just want to say thank you for tuning in so far, and thanks for popping into this video. If you found any value or entertainment or fun out of it or want to see more, then do let me know in the comments below. If you haven't already, do like, subscribe, and do tell a mate if you think this is kind of an insight into Australia, mate, or a content creator. If you're somebody who is aspiring to make some money, have a freelancing business, and this is just a kind of a keyhole into what you could do yourself. And I'm quite an average dude that's just believed in himself a little bit and got to, yeah, done all right. So just let me know in the comments the best takeaway you got from this video. I'd love to know. And let's have a little dialogue down below. Again, I'll see you in the next video.